Thank you. Then give me, made me move to my one question that I wanted to ask to all panel members before we move to opening the opening to questions from the audience. Is really thinking about what do you see as we see so different approaches, maybe different solutions. But how do you see as what do you see as the biggest challenge or the biggest challenges to really moving forward with resilience? Or you can, to sound more optimistic also, what do you see as the opportunities for of the moment that can help move forward with resilience? You were talking about aligning vision, yeah? So maybe Hans?
Maybe I start again. Well, I would say, you know, as a rational optimist, once again, goal alignment is a very good starting point.
Yes.
Goal alignment, yes. And if you have this alignment, you know, with some principles, we all are there too. That is a wonderful and a powerful start. Mm-hmm. And there are several things out there, as I mentioned this Millennium Development Goals, for instance. They are there almost now for 15 years. But we haven't taken that serious. We have missed targets, as I said, you know, in this achieving universal primary education. And once you have that, if people can read and write and they are also financially literate, then you can come in with ideas like in agriculture, good agricultural practices. And once you have that, then you can align with a lot of donor agencies because you're going in the same direction. Mm-hmm. You're going long term, you're going short term, you know. And this all, to my understanding, is really absolutely congruent on what Conal was telling about innovation, because, you know, I felt, well, I'm a little bit in the lion's pit here now, you know? but I feel like back home when I'm talking to the soup people. You know, we have a lot of soups at Nestlé. And and we have innovation teams at soups, you know? And they do innovate a lot of things. By the end of the day, it's still a soup. But it is about the ingredients, and it's about the way you put the different ingredients together, because I can tell you that the soup in northern Germany is not the same thing than the soup in South Switzerland or something like that. So that goes into the very local approach of what do you do building resilience into a food system, looking into food security, for instance. And therefore, once again, for me, the absolute key we should not miss this time is really the people focus. Mm-hmm. And the people focus is mainly bridging from our, this community here, where we are into a very academical and very intelligent, brilliant way, you know, putting concepts together, but having also a sharp mind of understanding really and having the insight to the target audience. Because if we do not understand what are the needs, the preferences of the target audience, and that goes more than just in the needs and the preferences, it's also about understanding their attitude and eventually influence to a certain degree their attitude, mindset, and the value set. You know, if you do not understand what moves, what brings people out, what triggers what, I think if we do not have a clear focus on people, then this whole debate on resilience may not resonate. It may satisfy our goals, it may whatever, but it may not impact mm-hmm. the target audience out there. That is extremely important. Mm-hmm. And maybe as a last word, you know, because I think we have learned, we have seen, spent so many money here, we have learned one thing for sure. Mm-hmm. We cannot donate people out of poverty. I think we all agree on that.
Yeah.
But we have also learned that we cannot certify rural communities out of poverty. So let us try to educate or to train people out of this situation they are to become more resilient.
Okay, educate. Okay.